Hey, what is going on, guys? Today I'm bringing you a quick tip video. It's something off the traditional types of videos I do, which are like 40 minutes long. Instagram TV only limits you to 10 minutes, but it's also cool because I don't have to go through a 40 minute long breakdown. I can just give you one quick tip that's helped me in my workflow, and I might upload this to YouTube as well, but it's a cool switch up in the types of videos I do. So today I want to go over adaptive sampling. Adaptive sampling has doubled my render times, even tripled them at times, and I'm just going to explain you what you need to know. It is a very basic tool to use, but it also can be quite complicated if you try and understand how it works. I'm just going to teach you the very basics. So here you can see it's at this bottom section here. I don't really have good examples of scenes which will show you the increase in render times, but I do have good examples of scenes which show you what it does. So let's go and reset the scene here. So here we've gone and turned it on, and then you'll get a noise shader that pops up at the bottom, and this is basically just a noise. It's just a visual representation of what it's doing. All the green areas of your scene, it's no longer rendering, so the background, it doesn't need that much rendering. Because you can see here most of this background is blue, and it doesn't really need that much to render. You don't need to waste your time rendering that. So now all the green areas of the scene are the parts of the scene it's not rendering anymore, which means that it only is rendering the parts that it needs to render, which is very good. That will save your render times, because now it's only rendering half the scene basically, and that also means you can bump up your maximum samples so that you'll have a lot more samples for it to render. But because it's only rendering like half of your scene now, you'll get more and more quality in these areas, which is very, very good. So all the green areas, it's not rendering, so it's pretty much just rendering this glass here, and this can really, really help you in terms of render times, and that can really, really help. So pretty much you don't really need to change any settings. If you do want to change settings, basically the minimum samples are the minimum samples it will render in your scene before it turns any of the pixels off. So if you want a minimum sort of quality, you can change it there. Your expected exposure is basically the expected exposure of the scene. Let's say a camera's exposure is at 2, you probably want to change that to 2. There are cases which is goes a bit advanced where you might want to adjust it depending on what sort of parts of your scene that you want, but generally on the brightest parts of your scene, it will stop rendering, because in this white part here, it doesn't really need to render that. It's just pure white, and the background, it also doesn't need to render that much. It's very blurry, you can't really see much. And the noise threshold here, it's basically if a pixel's noise level drops below this number here, it'll turn off the pixels. So if you turn this up, that means if you turn it up, that means it'll turn off pixels quicker. If you turn them down, that means it'll turn off pixels less quick. That's a basic, very, very basic look at it. It's a lot more advanced, and you can go read that up on the manual. But here you can see it's pretty much only rendering very, very small parts of the scene, and those are the parts that need rendering. It doesn't need to render the rest of the scene. The rest of the scene is pretty clear. There's only really grain in these patches here, which is what it's rendering, which is very, very good. So that's a bright scene example, and then I'm going to go through a dark scene example over here, which is a Razer keyboard, and sort of show you how you can turn off the darker areas of your scene as well, which can really, really save you some render times. And so yeah, I'm just going to import the scene over here and show you how this can really help you. So here in the scene, you can see that we have an empty space of a background which doesn't need rendering. So we're going to go and turn on adaptive sampling, and we'll take a look at our noise shader over here. Boom, the green turns off, the background turns off because it doesn't need rendering, it's black. Don't need to waste our time with that. And as time goes on, these black areas will start to go green. They're dark in the scene, as you can see here. They don't need to be rendering if it's completely black. And here you can see some of the bright areas, like the light parts and stuff like that. Those will also go green because it's very bright. Those parts don't need rendering. And then as time goes on, as the scene starts to render more and more, more of the scene will go green, and they'll stop rendering more of the scene as they actually get rendered. And then the only parts that need rendering at the end will be the blurry parts over here, which has a lot of grain in the bokeh, and that's pretty much all the computer will be spending time rendering in the end, which is very, very useful. So you'll see as time goes on, even the background over here and the floor and stuff will start to go green, which means it isn't, it's not rendering those parts anymore, which is super, super useful. So here is a case where I turned down my exposure level because I wanted more of the dark areas to be turned off and not just the bright areas of the scene, because most of the scene is just black and I don't need to waste my time rendering that. And I've also turned on the minimum samples just so I don't waste my time, you know, trying to get 256 samples in black areas, very, very dark areas. So that's pretty much why I adjusted the scene. So here you can see a lot of the scene is not even rendering anymore, which is very, very helpful. The only parts that are rendering are these areas up here where there's a lot of grain. There's a lot of grain in the bokeh over here as well. And those are the only parts that are really rendering the scene. So half of the scene, this whole section here, is not actually rendering, which is very, very good. It'll save you a lot of render time. You can also bump your samples up to like 60,000. Because half of your scene isn't even rendering anymore, so that means you can pump in more samples in the parts that do need rendering, which is super, super useful. But that's a quick tip from me to save you on render times in Octane Render. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you like more, just let me know and I'll make more. Have a good day and goodbye.